I don't know, dude. It's a good fight, honestly. It's a 50-50 fight just because the styles are going to, you know, because Rurley's kind of, you know, he seems like he's an inside fighter, and he, you know, and he's a little open in his shots, and
he's very strong.
He's strong for that, you know, for that reason. He looks like he's strong. But Pitbull has this style that real tight.
Very good defense, ball, hard to hit him. He's tiny.
And he's tiny, dude, and that makes it difficult for a fighter. But it's also his first time moving up to 140, so it could be different, you know?
Now, Jose, usually you're very, very popular. You're one of the few fighters that sells out stadiums. I don't think you've ever had a not sell out at home.
Am I right? We always do very well. Okay. We're blessed.
What do you tell fans? The tickets are on sale.
Tickets are on sale.
The fight's April 27th. You can go to Save Mart Center, a Ticketmaster, anywhere they sell tickets.
Exactly.
Today's the first day the tickets are on sale.
Yeah, they went on sale.
From your experience, how long does it take to sell out a Jose Ramirez fight?
Well, Ellie, you know, it's one of those things, man. Like, every time I walk out, it's always like, you can't get used to that experience. It's a beautiful experience to see the people, you know, cheering me on, and I could, you know, sense of like feel the vibration of the stadium.
They love you.
You know, it's just kind of shaking from the you know, from the excitement. But we expect something like that. You know, we expect another big, you know, big event, and I think boxing fans are really excited about, you know, to watch Virgil Ortiz, and Virgil Ortiz, you know, he just fought what less than 3 months ago. And for him to be back again, you know, again being consistent, that's huge. I know he's looking for, you know, he's looking for a big fight. He's hopefully he takes care of business, and then he goes and becomes a world champion next, you know. And I think people need to at least appreciate the fact that, you know, that fighters are staying busy for that, you know, for that matter, instead of just kind of waiting.
Of course, look, you know, he's 20-20 knockouts. He's a tremendous talent. He's,
and he's young,
26
dude.
This week. Can you get him a birthday 26. Present?
Dude, I just found out it was his birthday, like the day of, you know, but
get him a pair of shoes or something.
Yeah, you know, I will.
I'm joking. You don't have to get him anything.
Nah, he's a good man.
He's a good kid.
He is a good guy, man. Virgil, he's...
You sparred him, right?
Yeah,
How hard does he hit, Jose?
Well, you know, he is hard. You know, he hits hard, and he's technical.
Smart.
He's smart. He's very disciplined. He works hard. His dad and his team, Robert, everybody, you know, are working together to... You know, to get them ready, and same thing, you know, how I feel here. You know, they all work with me. I was working with Virgil Sr. for a little bit, you know, on small little details, and this gym we work hard, bro. Like, you know, this gym we don't like lazy people, you know. And if you are lazy, you stand out because you.
Kobe Bryant said, "I have nothing in common with lazy people."
Yeah,
because they're not on the same level. Like,
yeah.
Exactly. By the way. Jose, your son's here.
Yep.
Superstar soccer player. How old is he right now?
He's 8 years old.
Eight. He looks older than his age. He looks 11. Does that everybody say that?
No. I mean, just me. Just, you know, he's 8 years old. He's playing soccer. He loves it.
But he's in a superstar team with great players.
He's in a great team, Patito. He's in a good club. And what I mean a good club is that, you know, they stay busy. They you know, they travel. They've been to Vegas. They've been to San Diego. They've been to up in Northern California, Sacramento.
Do you go with him on all these trips?
In some of them, I've been blessed.
How is that for you?
Oh, dude, it's a blessing being a father, you know? You know, shout out to every father out there that is able to, you know, go out there and support the kids. And
he's only eight.
Yeah, dude, like, and I let him be, you know, one day he likes this and I support him, one day he likes that and I support him, but with soccer, he picked it up and it's like that, like, you know, I love it. And the reason why I know he enjoys it, bro, is because if you ask him a lot of players, like, you know, he knows about players, like, he watches a lot of soccer.
Who's the best soccer player in the world?
Ronaldo.
Messi.
Ronaldo.
Why Ronaldo, not Messi? No. He said Messi sucks. Nah, Messi just won the World Cup, right?
The thing about Mateo, like, he's been a fan of Cristiano Ronaldo. Maybe the swag, you know, and
the image, and his son,
the image,
yeah.
and
he's a very talented player.
Yeah, and he's like a huge fan of Cristiano Ronaldo. But like, you know, he follows a lot of the European soccer, so he likes like Holland. He likes. Mape, he watches all those guys.
Any favorite Mexican team?
Huh?
Do you like Chivas?
Yes.
Who's your favorite player?
Alonso Vega.
Vega, I think I met him once. He's been a national team. That same guy, right?
Yeah, for me, it was like, I was a Chivas fan with, Medina was playing with, El Bofo Bautista was playing. Like, you know, that's back in the day, Chivas, but I stopped watching soccer.
Why not boxing, though? Your dad's a very famous boxer, a champion, and all that.
Because soccer, you get to travel, and boxing, too. But you can't, like, after, you can go somewhere to eat. Like, I went to Dave and Buster's last time.
Because they have a good time. It's fun.
It's fun.
Boxing's like, not fun like that.
If you travel, if you travel to compete with boxing, you know, you have to be managing your weight.
Because you're going to hurt yourself.
That's true. You don't get hurt in soccer that much.
Yeah, you know. And
boxing is the hurt game.
Yeah, dude, like, as a dad, like, I know what it takes, you know. And honestly, like, I never really pushed him to be a boxer. I'm actually happy that he's not into it, you know. And but yeah, he's doing good. He's a good kid. He's a big brother now to two little sisters. So the family's growing.
I remember when he was born. Mateo, yeah. What's your favorite boxing fight of your dad? Your favorite fight of yours? Richard Comey? You like that one? Why?
Because my dad knocked him out six times, and that's it.
Okay, my last question. How does it feel when you go places and people come to your dad and want pictures and autographs? Are you used to it now, or is it always exciting when it happens?
It's exciting.
You still excited? That's cool. But he worked very hard to get. Nothing was easy for your dad. He was an Olympian. He worked very hard since he was your age, probably.
Yeah.
So you have to work hard.
I started when I was his age.
Yeah, but you have to work very hard.
Yeah, man, and that's one thing. That's one thing that it's hard as a dad to balance, because now he's, you know, he's more, you know, how he, where he's growing up and how he's growing up. It's very different than the way I was, you know, raised. You know, now he's in a nice house, he's in a nice, very diverse community. He sees, you know, at his age, he knows about brands, he knows about cars, he knows about all this.
What did you know at his age?
Oh, I grew up in a small
Avenue, yeah.
First generation community, farming community. No one had more than the other, you know. For me, when I got to sixth grade junior high, like my shoe that I always wanted to purchase was some Air Forces.
No, yeah. These are your own signature shoes, by the way. I'm going to show people your logo. Yeah. And you're a Nike boxer from day one, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, dude. Since I brought up the Olympics, Nike has been, you know, behind me. And
12 years. Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, and...
So that was your dream, to get Air Forces.
Yeah.
How many Air Forces pairs do you have now? 50, 100?
I probably own about 100 pairs.
That's badass.
But Air Forces, I wore them for like 2 months, and then I probably... Or like 2-3 times, and I send a lot to my uncles out there.
That's amazing, and they love it. That's very nice.
Yeah,
well,
saying, you know, size 10 is a very popular size. So.
That's very nice.
Even if it fits them a little bit bigger or a little bit smaller, they wear them.
Or straight to eBay, worn by boxing champion Jose Ramirez. No. I'm joking.
Nah, in Mexico, man, they wear it. Things are, you know, it's all good stuff.
So everybody, make sure you follow Jose at JC Ramirez 2012. Make sure you get your tickets now. Don't call me the week of the fight when it's already sold out. Do you know the price of the tickets yet, or?
I'm not sure, dude. I'm not, okay. You know, there's, I know, the floor seats, there's a high demand. A lot of them, they just kind of...
They sell out fast.
There's a lot of resale that happens, you know. So the prices go more than...
So buy them now before they jump up.
Yeah.
All right, there you have it. Well, I'm excited. Like I said, 3 weeks is fight week already. It's going to be fast.
Yeah.
And after that, nothing but the biggest names in the sport. So stay tuned. Jose Ramirez right here with his son, Mateo. Future superstar, the next Cristiano Ronaldo in the house. Mateo, say goodbye to everybody.
Bye.
All right, stay tuned. Ellie Stickback reporting.
3ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
3ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.